Android launchers are supposed to be quick, fast, and easy, and if they look good doing it, all that much better. I'm Joe Levi for Pocket Now, and this is a first look at LMT Launcher for Android. There are an awful lot of things that this launcher does, this of course being LMT Launcher on my Nexus 4. One of the drawbacks, first and foremost, is you have to be running a rooted device. The reason for that, well, there's lots of them, but to get in and do all the stuff that this can do, you've got to have root. Let's just put it that way, okay? So, let's take a look first of all at what we can do. This first thing is called Pi, and I think you can see why. It's shaped very much like a pie. Come over to this side so you can see it a little bit better. I've got two rows that I've set up. I can toggle Wi-Fi, go back, go to the menu, go home, pull up my search, quick launch into Gmail, Ingress, Star Trek, Google Talk, and Google Plus. You'll notice over here I also have the date and time, and I have some notifications scrolling in and off on the side, and they're animating and they look all kinds of great. One thing that I haven't done is I have not set up long presses, and that's primarily so I could show you this video in point. A long press, I can set up every one of these icons so that it has two functions. One, just what you see, and then another, what happens when you long press on it like I'm doing right now. Again, I didn't enable long press so I could show you this, but let you know you can do that, and it's really kind of cool. So, this is not stock. This is not the way that this app came pre-configured. In fact, configuration is a little bit tricky. Let's go in and look at how to configure the Pi, and then we'll get into some of the other cool stuff. This is LMT, and over here you've got all these settings. We'll scoot over here to Pi. If you want to change something in the Pi, you've got the level 1, that's the inside, and you've got level 2, that's the outside. Very quick, very easy. If we want to change, let's go back to level 2. Let's say I don't want to use Gmail. Let's say I want to use something else. I can choose an app or any of these other things in here. Let's choose an arbitrary app. And let's say I want that to be Bad Piggies. Tap that, go back home, and from now on, I've got Bad Piggies right there. I can quickly and easily launch that. Works great, works fast, I love it. You can get to it from either the side, the other side, or the bottom, which I have not enabled because I want to use my Google Now for that. When you set LMT up originally, you're just going to have one layer. You'll need to go in and set up the other layer, but when you do that, it wipes out all of the other settings. It looks kind of funny. The reason for that is all of your icons don't have icons. So when you come in, none of these guys are there. It just says app, which is really kind of lame. You don't know what it is, what it does until you launch it. So to get around that, come over here to settings, scroll all the way down to show app images. It defaults to 0, which is disabled. Go in here, use your keyboard, change that to 1, hit OK, and you're good to go. From then on, it will show you the app icons. It will also default to only launch from this side, at least it did on my install, but I want to also launch it from that side. So to do that, I just tapped on this activation area position, change it to left and right. I didn't choose left, right, and bottom. Again, I want to be able to use Google Now off the bottom, and those two would kind of conflict with one another, so I'm just choosing left and right. That seems to work best for me. There are really two other major components to the app. One is called gestures, and one is called invisible swipe areas. If you want to use either one of those, you're going to need to come in here and set the gesture input. If you take a look, here's a whole bunch of devices. You'll want to find yours in this list. Mine's a Nexus 4. Select that. Otherwise, things aren't going to work just right, and it did take me a little while to figure this out. It defaulted down here to the Evo 3D, and my swipes, my gestures didn't work. Once I did that, they work pretty well. Now over here on gestures, you've got all these different gestures that you can do, and the gestures let you do stuff. They let you launch apps, they let you change things, toggle stuff, all kinds of cool stuff. So what I've done is I've just very simply set up a swipe right double. What that means is I can take two fingers, swipe from the far left to the far right. Or this app, or this gesture rather, is the opposite, and then there's up, and there's down, and there's all kinds of cool stuff that you can do. But for this example, we're just going to use this swipe right double. If I want to change that again, same thing that I've used before, let's go ahead and open this up, take a look at it. Let's say I really like games, and let's do Angry Birds Space. We'll go back home. This is where I said it gets kind of tricky, and it's kind of hard to show on video. You take two fingers, swipe all the way across, and if I did that right, there you go. Just took a second. It will launch my app. Really quite cool what it can do. It's not quite as fast to recognize that as some might like, but that's a lot faster than opening up your app drawer and hunting around for the app that you're trying to launch and launching it that way. Overall, very cool. The one last thing that I haven't shown you that I'm going to leave you to play around with just on your own is this invisible swipe areas. It's kind of the same thing. You can set up an app, a recent app, a trigger, all kinds of cool stuff just by using this invisible swipe area where you can swipe in that particular part of the screen. Go in there, download the app, play around with this. Tell me if you like it in the comments over at Pocket Now. If you liked what you saw here with really cool launchers, in this case LMT, make sure you give the video a thumbs up. While you're at it, why not tell your friends on Google Plus and Twitter about it? For Pocket Now, showing off awesome launchers on Android-powered devices, I'm Joe Levi. Thanks for watching.